Today we're going to do something a little different. We're going to go hunting for garnets.
My adventures in Nevada brought me to Ely, the place to be if you're looking for gemstones.
Ed!
Well, how are you doing, John?
Good. How are you, sir?
I'm good. You're here to do a little outdoor stuff?
I am, and I understand you're the guy to talk to.
Well, I hope so.
Executive Director of White Pine County Recreation Board, Ed Spear, has been a rock hounder here since he was a boy.
And I understand you know a little bit about where I could go to hunt some garnets.
Garnets? Yeah, the closest one is Garnet Hill, and it's the most famous one. I mean, it's got lots of garnets on there.
I've heard of that one.
Yeah.
Will you take me there?
We're on our way.
Let's roll.
Known across the country as a rock hound destination, Garnet Hill spreads over a 2-square-mile area and harbors famous dark garnets.
Now, obviously this is called Garnet Hill, and probably for good reason, but is this like a needle in a haystack situation, or are they going to be all over the place?
Actually, it's like a needle in a haystack. If you look around here, all this rock has come from volcanic eruptions many, many millions of years ago, and any one of these rocks could be harboring a garnet.
When I find one, do I get to keep it?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely, you get to keep them.
I'm ready to go hunting.
Perfect. Let's go get her done.
All right, let's get her done. I think you have a friend up here somewhere.
He's supposed to be up here hunting garnets himself, so we may just have some luck today with Roger being up here.
Not only do we have to find garnets, but we have to go find Roger, too.
Roger Bowers is a retired geologist, or I should say semi-retired.
He's Roger, up here. It's a pleasure.
Pleasure to find.
Is he got here first? Is he getting all the good ones? Does the early bird get the worm? Is that what happened here?
Well, geologists normally do because they have an eye for the rock.
Roger Bowers worked here as a geologist back in the 70s. After retirement, he moved back to the place his heart never left.
How did this all get here? What are we looking for?
Well, we're on the top of a mountain, and the rock you're looking at is called a rhyolite. This is a type of rock, volcanic rock, and probably 12 to 15 million years ago, there was a volcanic eruption near here, and this was a hot ash. As it came down, it started to fuse together. I mean, this was 1,500 to 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit, and it trapped gas bubbles in it. So when you look at some of these rocks, they got these little tiny cavities in them, and they're called bugs. Well then, over the millions of years since then, the groundwater solutions, the rain, the weathering, the minerals, started forming the garnets inside of these bugs. And the beautiful thing about it, they had room to grow. So when you find a garnet, it's got the natural crystal faces on it.
And people like them for birthstones and just decoration, right?
Yeah, they're not a value as far as gem quality goes.
Yeah, but this is fun.
This
is a good time.
It's a blast.
Now, did I find one? I've got the bug.
Yep.
And then this is it here, this black dot?
Those are baby garnets. If you look real close, there's 3 or 4 different crystals in there, real small.
How big can these things get?
The largest one I've seen is about the size of a quarter.
So there's several ways to do this. You can just pick through the rocks like I'm doing, but you have tools.
I bring a hammer so I can break some of the bigger stones open. The other way to do it is just find some soil, use a shovel, and screen it. Because that way, Mother Nature has weathered the garnets out of the rock. But if you try to break them out, they're brittle and they'll probably break apart.
Ah.
So it's better to just leave them in the rock itself, which we call the matrix.
Can I try one?
Yeah.
Now, do you hit with the picker?
Yeah, no, just hit it right the way you got. Hit it hard.
I'm ready to try my hand at this. Maybe I'll have beginner's luck.
You know what I noticed about people in Nevada?
What's that?
They like to dig. They like to hang around rocks a lot. They like to walk through rocks. They like to drill into rocks. All right. This isn't necessarily easy, though.
No, that's a pretty hard one.
Learn that one. That's a pretty one.
Yeah, that's a good one.
It's in there. It's in there. This is so fun. I could do this all day.
It's addicting.
It is addicting. It's exactly what it is, in a very good way.
Yeah, once you find that first one, boy, you can get hooked real easy.
All right, so I'm getting better at this. I got a couple of babies, but I think I found a teen. Look at that one.
Oh, wow. That's a good one.
The geologist said that. That wasn't me. That was, hey, you know what? I'll trade you that for this.
Okay, that's a deal. See that? Nice crystal faces on there.
See?
That's what
you
got
to know what you're doing.
Absolutely.
Hey, thank you for this very much.
Well, you're very welcome.
What a great time. I really appreciate it.
Oh, it's fun.
And
it really
is. Thank you so much, sir.
Oh, you're welcome.
Absolutely.
One of the great things about this town is being able to do things like this for free, but it's also the people. I just want you to hear this. This guy's an auctioneer. Just give him something.
So, thank you, gentlemen. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
I am sold on this town. All you got to do is dig around a little bit, and you'll find a precious gem of your own in all kinds of forms.